Coming up with a brief?
About practice?
Yes, sir.
About practice?
Off season.
Yeah, off season going well. The new guys are adjusting well. I think got a good group in that back end, man. Travis is playing different positions. We real multiple back there. A lot of guys playing different positions. But I think it's going real good, man. I'm excited to see these guys come together in jail and perform. But with the new additions of the guys who come in, it's been great, man. Preston Hodge has been doing pretty good. He's played inside and outside, which is something that that's very valuable to us. That allows Travis to move around and playing inside too. If you've seen the last couple of times of practice, he's been playing majority inside. And when we can have him do that and be strong on the outside with Preston and DJ, it's going to be a sight to see for us out there. And we're excited about that part of it.
How has the transition gone from Coach Kelly now to Coach Livingston?
You know what? For me, it's the same. I got the same relationship with Coach Rob Livingston as I did with Coach Kelly. Their philosophies are a little different, but they both knowledgeable about what they want to get accomplished on the field. For the players, I think it's more of a putting more pressure on the outside and on the corners and the nickelback, because we're playing a lot more cover one, middle field close defenses. Last year we was more too high, so we put more pressure on the outside, put more pressure on the guys to make plays, but let them play fast, play to their strengths. So the adjustment to the players have been good because they understand, especially playing corner and the nickel, that all the pressure is going to be on those guys to get their guys covered.
When he came in, he said that he was going to change his scheme based upon talent in the building.
Mm-hmm.
Did he kind of arrive and then assert, you know, what was going on, or did he bring his scheme with him?
That's the biggest difference. You'll see in this system, he's going to make the players make the plays, right? Not just the system. With Coach Kelly, he brought the system in from Alabama, and that's the type of system that you have out that have to have guys in because you work in the system. When Rob got here, he wanted to evaluate the talent that we have in the room and then make that happen. You know what I'm saying? He's able to make some calls and make some adjustments to the defense to fit what we have in the room. And I think he's done a good job with that. I think the players understand that we want guys in position to make plays based off their ability. All right. And I think that's huge for the players, knowing that the calls are going to be made based off who we want to get off in the game. You know what I'm saying? The certain players that blitz good, they're going to be the guys that blitz. Guys that cover good, they're going to be the guys that cover. And I think that's huge for the players to understand that.
When you guys brought in DJ, you guys probably assumed you're getting a player that could play a lot of snaps for you. I mean, how much has he kind of lived up to the hype so far in spring? What have you liked about what he's been able to do so far?
He's been really surprising, man. The way he reacts, the way he understands and wants to be coached, because he understands that he got a ways to go, but he's able to come in and every day give us everything he got, understanding that he's trying to get better every day. He's been huge, man. His length, his knowledge, his ability to play on the football field, man, it's been amazing. We knew he was getting a player, but we didn't know he was getting a leader also off the field, and he's doing a good job of communicating on the field too.
Amarian Cooper played quite a bit of football for you last year. What have you seen out of him this offseason?
You know, Coop, we asked Coop to change positions this year, and he's really stepped up to the challenge, playing more safety, coming down, covering tight ends. Again, that's his strength, you know what I'm saying? And with the defense that we have put in, and he understands what we need from him, and he's doing a good job, man. He's a leader back there. Like you said, he played a lot of football, not only for me, but before he got here, and he's really taking the young guys under his wing, and by showing, you know what I'm saying, his role is going to be reduced than it was last year. But he stepped up and understand his role in this defense, and he's going to be a key guy for us.
Coach, how does Travis playing inside more, how does that take advantage of his skills, and how do you feel like that makes the defense better?
You know, that was my question too. How would he fit in there? Travis is probably, you know, it's not going to be a lot of them come around. he's able to get in there naturally and just play well in there. He's able to go in, and if we need him in the B gap, as you've seen a couple of times a day, he was able to fill that B gap. You know, getting a lot of nickels really don't want to do that, but he's able to do that. And being in that with the system going in college football now, the best receivers are no longer on the outside. So with him, you know, having the ability to go inside and us not lose a step on the outside, it's going to be real good for us. And we can match up and be able to take away their best guy by putting Travis on him on the inside if he's on the outside there. You know what I'm saying? So that it's going to be really good for us, you know, being that he's able to be really adjust like that for us.
From your perspective, what was the transition like for Trevor Woods? I mean, we've heard from the linebacker perspective, but you lost the guy who was, you know, a mainstay around here and then transitioned him. Why did you feel that move was right for him, or did you?
I did. I had talked with him about doing it even before we did it last year. You know, at the end of the year, he ended up going down and playing some in the box. I think that fits him better, especially in this system here. We don't have to bring another backer in. I mean, another DB in, because we have him. We can have the other backer blitz, and he can cover the tight end. It just works out well for him in the long run, being to his strength. You know what I'm saying? He's an in-the-box guy, and having him down there and having his ability to know what's going on with the defense, and that's a plus for us, man. Anytime you got a guy that's been around so long and has that many snaps, at a different position. If you didn't, last week, the other day in practice, we had a safety go down. We was able to plug him right in the safety and didn't lose anything. So Trevor's been really, really good for us, man, and because his knowledge of the game, you know what I'm saying, that's what makes him who he is.
Coach, what is Cormani's status?
Cormani came back today. He was out there running today. He got to get back in shape. Once he does that, you know, once he finishes running, he'll be back on the football field.
You mentioned a couple of the guys that changed positions. What about some of the younger guys, like Carter and James, that have moved positions?
You know, those two guys right there, man, it's disappointing that we don't get to see them now because they both injured. Jaden was doing pretty good before his hamstring injury. And we're just excited to get Carter back, man, because he's going to be another guy that we think they can play all three positions. You know, we put him out of corner. We worked him a lot. He's been working a lot at the nickel, but he can also go back to play safety. So we got some versatility in the room based off, you know, especially based off the defense that we're running. And it's going to be good, you know, when we get everybody healthy and back on the field.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you, Coach. Appreciate it.